Now to Christmas, the most magical time of the year, but also one of the most stressful and expensive. Add to that a cost of living crisis, and we have a perfect storm for a stressful, silly season.
Yes, so with just 5 weeks to go until the big day, 5 weeks today, I've compiled a list of tips to make it a little easier.
It's a Christmas list, but not as you know it. No naughty or nice here. To get on this list, you just have to make Christmas cheaper or easier.
Because Santa might have to tighten his belt this year.
We thought coming out of COVID that, you know, 2023 was going to be this year where everything got easier, and actually it hasn't been like that for most people. Globally, locally, it's been a really, really tough year.
And since Christmas is all about sharing, we got you lot to share some of your best money-saving hacks.
You've got to look at your finances and know that you can't afford to buy for everybody.
We tend to always do the one where everybody gives somebody a mystery present.
Our Facebook friends had some great ideas on making your gifts work harder. I used to give my kids a packet of chocolate biscuits as a stocking filler, just cheap ones. Don't underestimate the joy of a 10-year-old having a whole packet of biscuits to themselves.
Santa always delivered school supplies, pens, pencils, calculators, lunchboxes, school bags, etc.
One year, I even bought my son a 1 kilogram block of cheese. It was the best present he got that year.
Pretty generous gift too these days. I tell you what, speaking of gifts, here is my new favourite thing. My tip for you is try wrapping with fabric. Just get off cuts or old scarves or what have you. So many pluses here. Obviously, you can reuse it time and time again. Really good for wrapping unusually shaped things. You don't have to worry about the sellotape. But my favourite thing about this is it is so much faster than wrapping with paper.
Given that food and entertaining is such a big part of our Christmas celebrations, we thought who better to call on than destitute gourmet Sophie Gray.
Talk to the whānau, talk to everybody who's involved and decide how you want to do it this year. Just because you've always done it the same way doesn't mean that you have to.
Don't be afraid to mix it up.
One of the things I've observed is that we eat a lot of meat, you know, that they tend to be, you know, multiple choices. Have a little bit of a think about what is the thing that's really important. Make sure you have that. And if you're buying things because you just always buy them, perhaps there are some things that you can drop off there.
And always shop around.
You know, nobody is going to notice whether you bought the supermarket brand flour to make your pastry or whether you bought the named brand. It's all going to taste the same in the mix. I would also suggest that you try not to buy anything that you could realistically make yourself.
When she's not wearing her destitute gourmet hat, Sophie is the operations manager at the Good Works Trust Food Bank, making her well aware of just how tough it'll be for some this December.
We're seeing people reaching out to food banks for support who have never needed to before, and that's alarming.
And she says if you can help, now is the time.
Your little makes a difference when it's grouped together with everybody else's little. It makes a lot.
It's Christmas, right? A time for giving and also a time to remember what really matters.
Perfectionism is the robber of joy. That's the thing that makes you, worry, lie awake at night, spend more than you need to. You know, it doesn't have to be perfect. Aim for fun and have the things that are really important. Chuck out some of the rest.